You know, lately we've heard a lot of rim. Rim's gonna fail, or Rim's not gonna be able to compete in the mobile market, and while that may not necessarily be true, they've definitely fallen behind versus where they were 2 or 3 years ago. What's going on, guys? I'm Aaron from PhoneDog.com, and they're not taking that criticism laying down. Oh no! They're releasing several devices, one of which is the BlackBerry Bold 9930. Now this comes to Verizon on the 25th in retail stores, and is available now through telesales for $249.99, $509.99 full retail, and it's landing on T-Mobile and Sprint in the coming days as well. So is this a BlackBerry to get? Can it compete though with Android, with iOS, some of these devices that are either right at that $250 price point or even cheaper in the case of the iPhone? Can you recommend this when it's $50 more than the iPhone 4, which is a very popular device? We're gonna try and find that out in the review, but first, special thanks to my friends at Best Buy because they're hooking us up with a bunch of phones just like this. I just went and picked them up at the store today. Evo 3Ds, all kinds of good stuff for use in our One Paw Bandit game. So when you go into Best Buy Mobile, you don't deal with rebates. I hate paperwork. I'm sure you do too. I hate dealing with rebates. I hate those stupid debit cards too. You walk in, you walk out, you won't mess with any rebates at Best Buy Mobile. Let's try this out and see if this is a device to get, or perhaps you should go with something else. Maybe a Photon, maybe an Evo, maybe a Thunderbolt. We'll find out in the full review of the BlackBerry Bold 9930, which starts right now. So I'm gonna be honest with you, if you're watching this and you're like, is this a viable competitor to Android, to iOS, to Windows Phone, other things on the market, it is a viable competitor. Is this something you should get on Verizon? Well, it depends on the price point you're willing to spend, because at $249.99, this really isn't worth spending $250 on. I mean, it's an awesome phone, and I'm kind of spoiling the fun here at the beginning of the review, but this is an awesome phone. It's definitely the best BlackBerry yet, and if I had to give a contest by most sexy, and I hate using the word sexy when it comes to electronics, but if I had to rate the sexiest electronics, this would definitely be a solid number two, right behind the iPhone 4. Huge improvements on Research and Motion's part. That said, for $250, they're shooting themselves in the foot by pricing it $50 more than the iPhone 4 and placing it on par with all of Verizon's 4G devices. So the Thunderbolt, the Revolution, the Droid Charge are all $250, you know, somewhere between $199 and $299. Why would you buy this when you could buy a 4G device? I think that's going to be what's in a lot of people's minds when they walk into the Verizon store. Now, that said, you're an existing BlackBerry user, you're a BlackBerry diehard, you want something that's a great messaging phone. I mean, this thing takes the cake. I haven't been this impressed with a BlackBerry device in a long time. I'm going to be honest with you. BlackBerry 7 is a mild improvement, kind of mediocre there, you know, more evolutionary than revolutionary. But the keyboard, and this may come from the fact that I was originally a huge Bold 9000 fan. So this takes the Bold 9000, really upgrades it, adds a 2.8-inch touchscreen, and then adds some improved stuff, an improved camera, an improved design, beautiful metal accents, and takes it to the next level with a bigger keyboard. 6% larger than the BlackBerry Bold 9000's keyboard. So if you need a messaging device, this is the one. Now that's not to say, I mean, improvements on the web browser front are, I mean, freaking exponential. I can't even think of a better word to describe it. I mean, it's exponential. You know, I've been using it as part of my BlackBerry challenge, which you can see on the website. I'm using a BlackBerry for 30 days as a test, but I mean, this thing is just substantially better, and I can't say that I've missed Android or iOS yet. Now, I'm in day 4, so that's something to keep in mind. I'm still pretty new to it, but you can just see, and I'll walk through the specs with you pretty quickly here. 1.2 gigahertz Snapdragon processor. It has a 5 megapixel camera. Now, here's a big con. It doesn't have autofocus, so, you know, if you take a lot of pictures, if you take them outside and you're far enough away, it's not going to be a big deal, but no autofocus, kind of prone to fingerprints, but that's not a big deal. The other big thing, 1,230 milliamp hour battery. That's a small battery, and coming from BlackBerry's made the, or RIM rather, made the battery smaller, and they increased the processor speed. That's never a good combo, and as a result, you know, I get about 8 to 9 hours of battery life. This is not, BlackBerry users are going to be astounded at how poor the battery is in comparison to previous models. Now that said, the trade-off, much better web browsing, much better design, very thin, and very fast. But you can just see the speed difference here. I mean, I'm used to BlackBerry lag. There's no lag on this device. And you can see how fast this thing moves through the screens. I mean, things load up in an instant. And there's little to no lag at all. And I'm going to close that tab out so you can see. But I mean, it's just incredibly fast all across the board. And you see this even a couple of days in when I have a bunch of emails on my device. I'm using the same device as part of my test. But you can see, I mean, just zip along. No lag whatsoever. Open up. You see how quickly it moves. So I've been impressed with the speed. That 1.2 gigahertz processor was a win as far as I'm concerned on the Bold 9930. But anyway, you have your physical keys down here. You have send, end, BlackBerry key, which is kind of a right click. Think of it as a right click button, and a back button. I think I'm probably, part of me is happy just because this is not an Android device, because there's been so many Android devices, and I have nothing against Android, but the many phones that have come out this summer have been Android. It's kind of nice to review a different platform for a change. Nice to see something new. So RIM's not taking the criticism sitting down, rather, the criticism that, you know, they're not keeping up with Android, with iOS. They're releasing devices like this in the Torch 9810 and the Torch 9850 series to compete with some of the stuff on the market. The other two are a little bit cheaper. This one's pretty pricey. It's going to be a whopping $350 at T-Mobile. But again, very fast. You can see BlackBerry 7 here, and you can see, much like Torch, you can scroll over between your different frequent, all, favorites, media. And what I really like about this one is the ability to shrink down to just one. I'll show you what I mean by that. You know, I don't use favorites, I don't use media, I don't use downloads, I don't use all that stuff. I keep it at all. So I can go over here to options, I can change the home screen panels, and I can get rid of all of that stuff. So I can go to downloads frequent, get rid of it, and then all it shows me is all, and I can open it up that way. Now I can maximize the panel, but you just see how quickly it moves up and down. I mean, there's no lag whatsoever. It's pretty impressive. And I just can't get over how fast it is. But you see some minor icon changes. Otherwise, BlackBerry 7 is functionally almost identical to BlackBerry 6. No, not a huge change there. And actually, this was going to be BlackBerry 6.1. But RIM decided from a marketing standpoint to make it BlackBerry 7. But you can see out of the box, you get VZ Navigator and a couple of other programs and applications. You get Skype. You get BlackBerry Protect and BlackBerry Bridge, which I pre-installed. But Facebook, Twitter come pre-installed out of the box. You get Visual Voicemail, which is an additional $2.99. from Verizon. But let's jump into messaging quickly. Let's take a look at the keyboard, because this is the real bread and butter of this device. So we'll go in here, bring up old man, for example. We're going to text him, and we're going to say the quick brown fox is ready to party like it is 1999. Quick brown fox is ready to party like it's 1999. Now take a good look at this keyboard. I'm going to wait for the camera to focus in. It's a big keyboard, and it's 6% larger than the Bold 9000. So you look at something like this in comparison to the Torch 9810. This isn't a dogfight, but just to show you the difference. I mean, pretty substantial difference there in the key size. This is the one to get if you need a good keyboard, and you're, you know, your BlackBerry user, you need a good keyboard. Fantastic keyboard. This is one of those things, I send emails, for the past couple of days I've been sending them on the device just to see how long I can go without getting tired of the keyboard, and it's been incredibly impressive. My hands haven't gotten tired. It's perfectly roomy. So they definitely win in the keyboard department. So fast and easy to type on. Fast and easy to type on, according to my spelling. But you can see a good-looking device, and I'm kind of skipping around here quite a bit, but a good-looking device. This nice metal edge here, if you will, with some buttons on the side. You get your convenience key, which you can set to whatever you want it to be. A mute button, your volume rocker. Up here, your lock button, and then 3.5mm headphone jack. And micro USB charging port on the back. Cameras on the back with a flash, and then of course under the battery door, that 1,230 milliamp hour battery. But you can see it just looks good. It's a good looking device when it's laying down. Definitely a sexy phone. But let's load up web browsing and take a look, because this is where I really want to show you the improvements. We're going to load up phonedog.com just so you can see. And you know, I hope you've worked with perhaps a BlackBerry OS 5.0 handset or a BlackBerry 6 handset, because the changes here are just exponential, and a lot of it comes from the processor speed. We can open up new tabs if we want to, scroll back and forth between those, and you can see how quickly this operating system, or how quickly this device rather, moves. And so PhoneDog's loading up right now, and this is what you're going to be impressed with. And this is still, they definitely shorten the gap between BlackBerry 7 and iOS. The distance in terms of web browsing performance has been shortened now versus BlackBerry 6 and iOS. Now that said, it's still not quite up to par with Android or iOS. I would still probably reach for my iPhone or for one of my Android devices, my Evo 4G, my Droid 3, etc., before I went to browse on this. But I mean, the performance is substantially better. You can see, look how fast that is. Never did I think I'd see pinch to zoom that quick on a BlackBerry device. RIM says it's 40% faster and better than BlackBerry 6 and 100% faster and better than BlackBerry 5. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, I think it's 1,000% better, because I couldn't browse. Honestly, web browsing was totally useless on the previous devices. And part of that was due to the slower processor, and part of that was due to poor web browsing performance in general. Especially, you know, in BlackBerry 6, especially in BlackBerry 5, but in BlackBerry 6 as well. But you can see here, pinch to zoom, incredible. You're getting a little bit of checkerboarding, but nothing big. I mean, if I want to pinch to zoom, I can tap, go down, and just how quick and easy it is, and how well it works. I mean, I can't get over that. I mean, it's just much, much better than what we've seen on BlackBerry devices of the past. So is it up to par with Android and iOS? No. Is it going to be your ultimate web browsing device? No. But if you're coming into this and you're like, I really want the keyboard, I really want something that's a good messaging device, but I've always hated BlackBerry because web browsing just subpar, we want to take a look at it again, because they've definitely improved a lot in that department. So, I mean, much, much better than web browsing. I can't get over
the web browsing department. Of course, you can add the bookmarks, add the home screen, send page address, and copy bookmarks in history, do some things like that. But again, a little bit of checkerboarding. As you can see, it's just a significant improvement over past BlackBerry devices.